نحمد ونصلي على رسوله الكريم أما بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم والعصر إن الإنسان لفي خسر إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر صدق الله العظيم. So the task that I have today is to speak on time management. And from us sitting here, anyone struggles with that? Time management, procrastination. If you pick up your hand, if you're a little bit on procrastination, who's a, as you say, a night owl? Any night owls? Night owls? MashaAllah. Okay, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions and tells us in the Quran that I've, the ayat and the surah that I've mentioned, Surah Al-As, Allah Ta'ala speaks about time, us, with regards to time. And what Mulana mentioned, that when you look at your, when a person passes away and then you have a board before, and then there's a small dash, and then you see the you know, when a person passed away, and your life is just that small dash that's there. So in the context of time, our life is, it's a small blip. You know, if you had to put on a timeline, and what's my life, you'll see it's just a small blip and it's gone. And in that small time that we have, and mashallah, the speakers, they gave so beautiful advices on doing good work and being a positive change for society. And alhamdulillah, you know, that it was so inspirational. But my topic is slightly different. Mine is about the practical aspects. How do we actually do everything? How do I, how can I do social work, humanitarian work, concentrate on my studies? Sometimes people have responsibilities. Sometimes people have to work. Sometimes people have to travel from far distances just to come and study. So, and with all that, I still have my responsibility to my Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So how do I manage all of that? And we can only get our inspiration from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And so from the context of time, just for us to understand, Imam Shafi'i rahimahumullah mentioned that if we have to just ponder on this surah, it will be enough for our guidance. That to think that my life is so short, and for us to get this reality, you know, we think about those that have passed away, sometimes young people that have passed away. And you realize how short life is. And as you go along in life, you realize, you know, that 20 years has passed, and now the next 10 years will pass, the next decade will go. And before you know it, you at the end of your life. So in this short period of time that we have to maximize our time. But Allah Ta'ala also has told us in the Quran that we have created men and jinn for the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But it doesn't mean now 24 hours must be in the masjid as well. You know, we are human beings, we need to eat, we need to have social interaction, we need to relax a little bit, no problem with that. But if we are not going to be focused on our time, then before we know it, we will be at a loss. But Allah Ta'ala also in the surah tells us that there are few people that will be exempt from this. إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, those that have iman, those that believe, and they do righteous deeds, and they do good deeds. So you're studying here, just by the change of intention, it's a righteous deed. So you can come to university and have a correct intention. Your entire study, if you're studying for 4 years or 6 years, it's ibadat, because your intention is correct. So we can spend our whole life just with the subtle change or shift in our mind of niyyah, our whole study period can be in ibadat. Similarly, once we stop studying and we go into the real world and we're working now, and just with a shift of niyyah, it becomes ibadat. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in Surah Al-Asr, and then Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned that there are two blessings which many people lose, their health and free time for doing good. So inshallah, the time that we have, if we balance our time and we plan ourselves, and we will then be able to do good. All right, So let me share a small history of myself. And as I mentioned, this segment, it's more about practical tools that we're going to have or we can use. So what's the general age of my brothers that are here? General age? Anyone first time out of matric? How old are you?
In the morning, most of the guys were first years.
In the morning, most of the guys were first years. Okay.
Now I would say 25.
Early 20s. So when I finished matric, then there was a friend of mine, he told me, you know, let's go to a Darulum. I never know what I'm going to study. So he told me, you know what, let's go to a Darulum, let's take a gap year. I said, all right, that's great. And I can at least maybe do my hivs. And so we went to the Darulum. Alhamdulillah, I thought it would take me 1 year, but I still had quite a few paras that needed to be completed. And so in the next year, while I was studying, and it was a Thursday night in the Darul Ulums, you know, Friday normally is like off. It's your holiday. And my dad picked me up and we were talking, we went and visit a few people in the hospital, and then he told me something very beautiful, you know. He mentioned this ayat of the Quran, La yastakhiruna sa'atu wa la yastakdimun, that your time will not be increased by a second, nor will it be decreased by a second. This was on the Thursday evening after we went to the hospital. And then he mentioned about my brother who had passed a few years earlier than that, around 98, about 2 years. And he was about 2.5 and he passed away with cancer. And this was what the advice my father was giving me. And then the next day, you know, you wake, stay up late at night, you know how it is. And I went to bed late, but I knew my dad had come into the room. And he was doing some relief work in Mozambique. And he passed on in an accident above his age of 46. And so I'm 19 years old, and we're now faced with a critical situation because my dad was running an institute called Ashraful Ulum or Ashraful Aid, which is a branch of Ashraful Ulum. And I'm now 19 years old, I'm not even a hafiz of Quran. I just finished 1 year out of school. And we faced with this, that what do we do now? And so I made mashwara with my mother. And then we said that, you know, the family was with us. And we took the decision that we're going to carry on with it. And it was a hard decision because, you know, I'm only 19. I don't know anything about running an organization. So what happens in that case? My mom, she couldn't even drive. So I never had the skill. Like normally if you're running a madrasa, you're supposed to be an alim or a hafiz. Or I never had the qualification of running an organization, only 19 years old. And so I was put into this situation where you needed this much of skill and I'm only on this level here. So you like actually you've been thrown in the deep end. And I know when my dad passed away, the organization funds was only 1,000 rand. Because my father, alhamdulillah, was well known as an alim and he always believed that, you know, as we need, Allah provides. So that was his philosophy. And like we look at when Nabi Salasim passed away, there was little funds. When Sayyidina Abu Bakr passed away, they utilized what needed to be utilized for the poor. So there was 1,000 rand in the bank account. And, you know, now we had to pay salaries and carry on with the work. So quickly what I had to do was to come up to this level. You know, so I'm here, I have to be on this level. And so I then put all my energies into self-development. So I carried on with my hips, but I also, in to have the skills that were needed, I had to then open books, speak to people, what makes a person effective. I had to learn persuasion skills. You know, the as you say now, the soft skills, you know, persuasion skills, time management. And so up till today, I enjoy it because I know how much it helped me as developing as a person. So that's a little bit of my history. And this was what was happening in my head. You know, all I had, at one stage, I remember writing down all the things that I needed to do, and I literally had 99 things to do. When I wrote my what I needed to do, 99 things. And so I'm like thinking, oh, hell, where am I now? What where do I start? 99 things to do. So this how, this is my before picture, all right? Let's see my after picture. Okay, this is how I am today, alhamdulillah. So I would like to share some of the skills that I've learned over the years, and inshallah, it will be beneficial. We see, you know, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the best example for us. And just studying the life of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam teaches us how to live your life, but there's different levels. One is, you know, what Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells us, but what we can also learn is how Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam done things. So observing the life of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, so you're learning what you can learn on two levels. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as we know, is the most influential man in history. Okay, so I then said, all right, let me look at the life of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and see how Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would structure his day. And there's a very beautiful book that came out now recently. It's called Al-Yawm al-Nabawi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, A Day in the Life of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And it tells us how Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would spend his day. And what is so remarkable was that with all this fikr Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had, but there was a sort of this calm in which Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would do things. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and ulama mentioned that Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would divide his day into three parts. The one part would be for himself, for his own worship, for his own sort of, you can say, your self-development. The other part would be for his family, and the other part would be for humanity. And this is how Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would structure his day, just in a simplistic form. And so if we take the same concept, that we need to structure our life in the same way, that one part needs to be for our own self-development. Alhamdulillah, we meet people today, you know, we meet the wealthiest of the wealthy, and we meet the poorest of the poor. A few months ago, I was in Syria in the refugee camps. But obviously, for us to do that work, we need to meet the richest of the rich, get the money from them to give to the poor. So we meet both ends of the spectrum. So Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it's the best of examples. So we need to give ourselves time as well. So we meet many people, alhamdulillah, they might have worldly things in their life, but they don't have any time for themselves. How many cases we do, marital cases? You know, the person, I'm so busy in my career, but he doesn't have time for himself, he doesn't have time for his wife. He doesn't have time for his family. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was a perfect example, time for everyone. And so if we just segment ourselves into three, time for myself, my worship, my Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, my ibadat, my self-development, time for me to do what I need to do in terms of earning my halal risk, and time for my family, okay? And with time of doing things, we also separated a little bit more, or if in your self-development time, where we can give to society, give back to society. So if you look at the effect of people in their life, they say, and I'm coming now to the, you know, with the drums rolling part now. They say that simplicity is the ultimate sophistication. Simplicity is the ultimate sophistication. So in order to have a very balanced life, it's very simple. It's first to have little bit goals, and to set some goals so you know where you're going, which direction you're going. Our goal is obviously the akhirat, but our short-term goals is this dunya. Right now you want to study, you want to finish your studies, so it's your short-term goal, but you know that the true goal is our akhirat. So we align our short-term goals of this dunya to the long-term goals of the akhirat. And so there's a very simple system that we can use. One is to have a schedule, meaning a calendar. You have a calendar. Everyone got a smartphone? You just take out your smartphone. Everyone got a Gmail account? Or if you have iPhone, what's it called? iCalc or something like that. Huh? You got that. So everyone got a calendar, all right? And Gmail, it's easy, all right? So the first thing is to have a schedule, meaning to have a calendar. Second, to have your tasks, to note down anything that needs to be done, so you take it off your mind. And The third thing is to prioritize, because not everything needs to be done. And as you get more clued up and more better, more equipped, you realize that not everything is that important. Okay? So we try to focus on things which are important, and when we say important, more impactful. All right, so the first thing that we need to do is to have a calendar. I don't know if you can see it. This is a sample of a calendar wherein you time block. You time block. So for example, if I show you my calendar here and I'll pass it around, this is my day. Right? You can just pass it around. This is my week. I plan every week. So in the morning, you can see I'll put 1 hour. I put in ma'amulat, meaning it's the time I spend with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I read my Quran, I make my dhikr. Then I got time. I time block, and this is important that you write it into your calendar. And this other time is for exercising, because health is also a great ni'mah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then from there, I have a few periods of time which I'm a little bit free, so now I can a little bit relax a little bit. Then I go to madrasa. From there, I go for my different meetings which I calendar it in. And then in the evenings, I would have calendars for my family time. Now I know from this time to this time is my family time. Okay? And basically, that's what it is. And I've now put that what time I need to unwind. So from like, I know 10 o'clock, 10 p.m., I start unwinding. It takes me about half an hour. I'm unwind, and then I try to go and sleep. So just having a calendar is how you can have more barakah in your time, because you're taking all things that needs to be done and you're taking it off your mind and you're planning it and you're putting it on your calendar. And it's very easy that in school you have a timetable, am I right? For one period. Then after this period, you have a next period. So all you have to do is the same concept, just expand it a little bit more. So after school, this period to this period is the time I'm going to relax. This period to this period, I'm going to study. This time to this time, I'm going to now again maybe relax or spend time with my family. And on the weekends, again you time block. So it's very, very simple. Okay? So inshallah, if you can start time blocking, you'll see you'll have enough time. You'll have enough time, because you're taking everything that you have in your mind and you're putting it nice, and you know, all right, from this time to this time. Like for example, in our organization at Ashraful Aid, I know Mondays is my meetings which I set up with all the people that I need to do. So we have different teams around the world and the teams at home. So we set up meetings on Monday. Tuesday, I know it's more in terms of the marketing team or the marketing day or marketing theme. Wednesday, it's more in terms of operations. Thursday, it's a little bit flexible, but we sit with finance. And Friday, I try to leave it a little bit flexible. So anything that needs to overflow, I know I can catch it up on Friday. So just having that in terms of a system, alhamdulillah, you know, I've taken all this, I need to do this, I need to do that, I need to do this, and putting it onto my calendar. Then I have time to do everything. I have time with my wife, I have time with my kids, I have time for my health, I have time for my Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I have time to do good as well, that gets calendared in as well. That on this day I'm going to be doing this, like I'm coming here for this program to give a talk, it's calendared in. I know that I have this responsibility. You all know what that is? Who's got that app? Anyone's got that app? It's Google Keep Notes. Sometimes you have different notes on your phone. So I was speaking with one alim, very prominent alim, and we were in Medina Manawara. And I asked him that, Mulana, how do you do so much of work? How do you do so much of work? You know, you're in a school, you run madrasas, you do so much of da'wah, you're on the radio. And he gave me a very simple answer. He says that he just took out that time, you know, the small calendars. He says, whatever comes to my mind, I just take it. And I take it off from my mind and I write it down. And so anything that comes off, if you can get into this habit of something comes, I need to do this, you just take it and you put it. So something like Google Keep or what you have on your phone, most of your phones, you just take whatever you have on your mind and you put it off. and you take it off from your mind, so that there's no more mental pressure. All right, and then the next thing. So now you have maybe 10 things that needs to be done, but not everything is important. So you need to ask yourself, what's urgent? All right, urgent and important. Someone falls down, someone gets hurt. It's urgent and important. You need to attend to that. But you try not to love your life urgent and important, because then you'll be stressed out. Then you have things which are not urgent, but are important. Okay? And that's where you try to love. You try to do the important things, but they're not urgent. So very few things must be in your urgent and important, but you try to love mostly in important but not urgent. And then you look at the third block in the matrix, you know, things which are not important but are urgent. Sometimes things are urgent, like you get maybe an email, but it's not maybe so important. All right? And then you have things which are not urgent and they're not important. So for example, maybe, you know, surfing the net or Netflix, you know, it's not urgent, it's not important. So then that's how you prioritize. Even when you're doing your calendar, you can say, all right, I need some time to unwind, maybe to surf the net, to check my Facebook, to check Instagram, what's happening. And then you schedule that time in. So like, for example, if it's your study time now, you know, it's for half an hour, I give it my all at that period of time. And then for the next 15 minutes, then I can check my Instagram, check whatever messages, WhatsApp, okay? So, alhamdulillah, this is something, inshallah, we'll share this slides with you all as well. So Mulana put something else there with regards to time management. How do you become disciplined? You know, because you can have it, but how do you actually become disciplined? So discipline is very simple. Discipline is habit. Okay? So for example, I was a night owl. I can work by default, I can work at night. I can push the whole night. Okay? But obviously the next day I'm flat. But Nabi SAW said, Allahumma barik li ummati fi bukuriya. Nabi SAW made dua for the ummah, that Allah bless my ummah in the early part of the morning. And Nabi SAW should start his day with the Sahaba Ikram after Fajr Salah and listen to them and give them advice after Fajr Salah. And Nabi SAW's dua is for the ummah in the early part of the morning. So how do I become maybe an early bird? And how do I get that discipline? So the discipline part is only the first maybe few weeks, sometimes 40 days, 66 days, you know, people. So once you start focusing that maybe for this 2-3 weeks I'm going to wake up, what happens? It becomes habit. And so it moves from being disciplined. So you need the discipline only for that short period of time until it becomes a habit. And once it becomes a habit, it's part of you, it becomes part of you. Like today I was up after Fajr, alhamdulillah. And I'm saying this not because to boast, but just to show that I managed to read 3 paras of Quran. I managed to do large part of my adhkar. I spent time with my family. I had a very good breakfast. You know, while before I was coming here, I was going over like some of my prep work, you know, surfing the net to see what else. And I'm reading the life of Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam about how he helped his wife. And I saw my wife, she was in the cleaning mood in the morning. So I said, let me practice on the sunnah. And I said, let me do some extra work, you know, and I got some points there, alhamdulillah. So I managed to spend all that time. I managed to do some deliveries for family members. And then by the time I came here, Mulana said, how come you're here about you so early? I said, it wouldn't be nice. I'm talking about time management and I'm late. So alhamdulillah, this is only from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the main thing, inshallah, also to have barakah, is to do a lot of adhkar, to do a lot of dhikr, to read a lot of durood. And our ulama, our ustads, they mention that sometimes, you know, just having like a tasbih in your pocket, you know, it's sort of like a prompt. You can keep it in your pocket, or you have that electronic ones. It's just sort of like a base for you to, like a reminder for you to, let me make dhikr. So if you're standing in a queue, you're waiting in a line, just put your hand in your pocket and naturally you start making dhikr. So inshallah, also doing dhikr, reading darood, salawat on Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, you start sensing that barakah, making istighfar, astaghfirullah. As the brother mentioned, we're in this environment and you know, we can maybe swallow us up, but inshallah, by making dhikr, thinking of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, making istighfar constantly, you'll see the barakah in your life. So inshallah, I hope it was beneficial. And inshallah, if we can only advise you that, you know, start using your Google Calendar. It makes a major difference in your life. You know, plan your life out. Plan your time when you're going to have fun, when you're going to go out with friends. All that must be there, but just calendar it and get into the habit while you are young. You'll see the benefit of it as you're going through life. May Allah Ta'ala grant us tawfiq and grant us barakah in our life. And may Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala accept all our efforts. Jazakallahu khairan.